हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 10th। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर इंग्लिश स्टडी टुडे। चैप्टर 9, द सर्मन एट बनारस। बनारस यू नो वेल फेमस सिटीज नेम एज वाराणसी इन यूपी। ए सर्मन, सर्मन मीन्स उपदेश, प्रीचिंग। एक उपदेश बनारस में। यू नो व्हाट इज द सर्मन ऑफ बनारस? It's taken from the means autobiography of Buddha religion, the great person of Gautam Buddha. I think students you are knowing about Gautam Buddha, who was the founder of Buddha religion. Okay, Bodh religion means Gautam Buddha was belonged to royal family. You know. Means Gautam Buddha born in North Indian royal family. His father's name was Suddhodana, who was the emperor of the kingdom, king of the kingdom Kapilvastu, King Suddhodana. And you know Gautam Buddha's childhood name was, you know, whatever his childhood name, Siddhartha. His name was Siddhartha. And Siddhartha's mother became died in his early childhood days, so his father has nourished him well. Okay, and Gautam Buddha went for the higher studies for the Hindu, whatever in religion he had got some knowledge from there. And after that, after finishing education, means in his early age, 17th year, he got married with a charm of beauty, a princess whose name was Yashodhara. He got married and he have a son also after 1 or 2 years whose name was Rahul. Okay, so in this way Gautam Buddha was spending his luxurious life in his palace. Means King Suddhodana have available overall facilities, whatever pleasures in his palace. Okay, once Prince Siddhartha want to visit the city, what is the condition of city he want to see, and he went with his charioteer Channa for seeing the condition of city. His charioteer Channa and he went there in their hiding of their, you know, personality, because if people will know about his royalty, then means that time they will feel about it. Firstly, they went in their condition, royal condition. That time whole the city was well decorated and everyone hiding their real condition. But after visiting the whole city, Siddhartha decided that he have not seen reality. Then means he desired again and decided again to visit that city in actual condition. And this time they went there in their hiding, their post, as he went there as merchant. Okay, in merchant means garment they went there, and then he had seen the actual city condition. He had seen an old man. He had seen a sick man who was means shouting there with the pain. And then at last he had seen a corpse. People were going with the Ram Naam, Satya Hai. In this way, they were crossing the road. Then Prince Siddhartha had asked to Channa, what is it? Then Channa have explained about it. It was a corpse and everyone will die one day who have taken birth. And then he have seen an old man who was crossing the road having very weak condition. Then means Prince Siddhartha had asked about him. Then Channa again explained he was an old man and each and every man will be old one day in their last age step. That time means when he returned back at home, he said it is enough. And he was means become in deep sadness, deep thinking. What is the salvation of these means pain and these sadness of the world? He started to searching the salvation. And one day he decided to leave the palace. And at night he had left the palace and he went there for searching the solution of mankind's pain and sufferings. Okay? And after that he had started to preaching. After that he had started to given sermons place to place and become popular because he got the knowledge under the tree of Bodh Vriksh in Bodh Gaya, Bodh Bihar, and he got the knowledge in his deep meditation and thinking. And after that he had started to means given sermon. So it is a first sermon he has given in Banaras. So the sermon at Banaras, whatever he have given, let's start the story of a lady and how he have convinced that lady about the reality of the world. Okay, because death is the real truth in this world. Once there were lived a lady whose name was Kisa Gautami. Kisa Gautami's son unfortunately being died. And Kisa Gautami become very upset. She was visiting here to there and asking house to house about the medicine by which her son become alive. And her son become died because, you know, it's due to mother's hurt. Everyone become emotional on that time when their child being death in front of themselves. It is very unpleasant moment in this world. Kisa Gautami also become upset and very sad. She was wandering here and there, day to day, night to night, searching for the medicine, searching for the solution for being alive to her son. Then once a man have told Kisa Gautami about Gautam Buddha. He had told to her, you can get solution if you will go near to Gautam Buddha then. Okay? Then Kisa Gautami decided to go near and she decided to meet Gautam Buddha. When Kisa Gautami reached there, then Gautam Buddha have told her about the solution. He had told her means about the death and life. What is gap between that? But she was unable to understand. Then Gautam Buddha have given her a work. Go and ask some seeds of mustard from which house, where which house members have never seen any death. Go and ask one handful of mustard, then your son will be alive. And Kisa Gautami become very happy. She went from there and she was searching, asking house to house, place to place about the mustard seed. Then peoples have told her about the death, about the tragedy of their houses. After listening a large number of stories, she also become conscious. And she was knowing the truth. Death is universal truth. It will come in everyone's life one day. No one is immortal. Man and we human beings are mortal. We will die one day. Then peoples have told about the stories. Then she become very sad. And being disheartened, she sat the side of the road. And she was thinking that she was so selfish. She had made the sad a lot of peoples by their tragedies, remembering of their tragedies. She was so selfish. Even सी बिकम कॉन्सियस एंड सी बींग वेल नोन दैट एंड सी अनेबल टू फाइंड द मस्टर्ड सीड फ्रॉम दैट हाउस हैविंग नो डेथ एंड सी वेंट एंड मीट टू गौतम बुद्ध नेक्स्ट डे. देन गौतम बुद्ध लॉफ्ड एट हर एंड ही हैव टोल्ड हर अबाउट द मीन्स एक्चुअल एंड रियल ट्रूथफुलनेस ऑफ लाइफ. As the sermon he have told, man is mortal, no one is immortal, and everyone is die one day. So you are not only example of those peoples. Everyone's life, it's happen, it is common, death is common. And from that day, Kisa Gautami also realized these things, and her pain and sadness means short. And she have left these things, whatever she was doing as the mad. And she become sensitive. Gautam Buddha asked her looks for these things. Means in whole the world, no one is as, means who not be die one day, if he have taken birth. Okay. In this way she realized these truth. And whatever Gautam Buddha want to understanding her, that being fulfilled. According to Gautam Buddha, you know, sadness and grief, it increases human beings pain and suffering. Okay? We should not be sad in our sad days. We should be in patience and courage. Whatever in our life, we should face it courageously. Because everyone's life means happy moments and sad moments comes. Okay? Means in this way, we can say that happiness is blessing of the God. Okay? And sufferings is means the punishment given by the God, whatever our activity we have done in our life. Okay? In this way, the sum up of this chapter of that means Gautam Buddha want to tell the mankind means all the sufferings will come one day and everyone will die one day, but we should face it. Okay, thanks, that's all.